Okay, good afternoon students. Today I will explain you a binary system, that is diopside anorthide system. And yesterday I explained albite anorthide system, which was complete solution series. How? So you know the certain rock forming minerals in which neither the composition of solid is fixed nor the composition of melt while melting. So this type of minerals show complete solution series. So plesioclase was the typical example of complete solution series, where the composition of solid was not fixed and the ends of the tie line show the composition of the two phases that exist in equilibrium with each other at that temperature. So in which a top portion was liquidus and the lower portion was solidus. Top line liquidus and bottom line was solidus. So when any composition melt cools at any point, the product that the first crystal will form, and it will be 90% calcium. That's why it was anorthite, as I already told you yesterday. So after decreasing temperature, melts reached as another point and produced the other crystals. So then after cooling, it reached the final solid solution, that is the binary eutectic point. And at this point, the composition of solid would be equal to the composition of liquid at initial stage, that is the starting point. So the new composition was albite 50, anorthite 50. Okay, it is clear to all of you. That is the albite anorthite system. So today I will explain you the diopside anorthite system. So let's start with the diopside anorthite system. So this is a simple eutectic system. At point E, you can see in your diagram the temperature 1275 degree centigrade. Diopside, that is point F, begins to crystallize along with anorthite, that is point I. And the liquid cools to 1490 degree centigrade, that is point G, at which point pure anorthite crystallizes, that is point H. You can see in your diagram. I will show you later on. So at point E, the ratio of anorthite and diopside is 42:58. So diopside crystallizes first. At point E, so it is joined by the anorthite, that is I. Now I will explain you in figure. See the figure. See the diagram. The two components are the calcic plesioclase, that is calcic plesioclase, that is anorthite. It is a tectosilicate mineral, and a diopside, a single chain isosilicate mineral. This is a isosilicate mineral. So we start with a system rich in diopside component. This is diopside rich component with a composition of anorthite 20 and diopside 80. Here you can see at this point, albite, sorry, anorthite and diopside ratio is how much? Anorthite 20 and diopside 80. So at a temperature above the liquidus temperature for this composition. So as the system cools, it will eventually intersect at the liquidus at a temperature of 1350 degree centigrade. That is point B. This is point B. Here you can see the temperature 1350 degree centigrade. And to determine the composition of the first crystals, this is the composition of first crystals. A horizontal tie line AB. This is horizontal tie line AB is drawn between the liquidus and solidus. So the intersection of the tie lines with the liquidus point B represent the composition of liquid, that is anorthite 20 approximately. Because the mat has just begun to crystallize and its intersection with the solidus at point A, that indicates the composition of first crystal, that is diopside. So this is the first crystal of diopside at point A. Okay. So as the system continues to cool, diopside crystals continue to form and grow, increasing the percentage of solid diopside in the system. So as the system continues to cool, 1315 degree centigrade, that is the tie line CD. The composition of melt continues to change incrementally down the liquidus lines to the D. Here you can see the temperature was 1350 and here the temperature is 1315. So it down the temperature. While the composition of crystallized solid remains pure diopside at point C. At point A and C, pure diopside. So as we continue liquid composition, we evolve the liquidus and solid composition evolve down the solidus at point E. This is the point E. Until the vertical system composition line intersection of solidus at point E. This is the point E. And after which any further cooling brings the system into the 100% solid. That is diopside plus anorthite field. This is 100% solid. So as the system approaches 1275 degree centigrade, this is 1275 degree centigrade, that is tie line EF. This is tie line EF at a temperature of 1275 degree centigrade. It contains a large proportion of diopside at this point, at point F. And a smaller proportion of melt with the composition anorthite, how much? Approximately 42%. This is 40 and this is approximately 42% anorthite. So when the system reaches the eutectic point, this is the eutectic point. I have already told you what is a eutectic point. That is the constant proportion in which the two constituent simultaneous crystallize. So here you can see the solid at point 1275 degree centigrade. where the liquidus and solidus intersect the remaining melts, crystallized completely by the isothermal eutectic crystallization of diopside and aurthite until all the melts has been crystallized. So the cooling off system below 1 to 75 degree centigrade below this line causes it to enter the all solid diopside plus anorthite. So below this line, this is FE, this is tie line. So below this line, you can get solid diopside and anorthite field. Now, which mineral crystallize first from a magma? That is the first form mineral, mineral A. Depends on the specifics of melt composition. That is the melt composition. It depends upon the specific melt composition. And the separation of crystals from melt generally cause melt composition to change. Or you can say multiple minerals can crystallize simultaneously from a magma. And this means that no standard reaction series. This is a no standard reaction series. So this is all about diopside anorthite system. If you have any query, you can ask me any question.